corner of your smile and all the little things no one will ever know. Like it was yesterday, won't ever fade away. Goodbye is just a word I will never say. You will never be forgotten. A million days could pass us by, but what is time but just a dream? Oh, I still feel you here with me. You're more than just a memory. Your eyes, and when I talk to you, it just echoes in my mind. But if hearts are made of dust, and if we fell from the stars, I'd look up tonight and know just where you are. That you're
you have been there to love and gives me the faith that I'll see you again. The lessons that you taught me will be shared and held dear. Each life that touches ours helps God's love become more clear. You are warm and not forgotten. Your love is in my heart. You're warm and not forgotten. Your life has played a part in the lives of all who knew you here, and your journey has no.
I wanted you for life, you and me in the wind. I never thought there'd come a time that our story would end. It's hard to understand, but I guess I'll have to try. It's not easy to say goodbye. For all the joy we shared, all that time we had to spend, if I had one wish, I'd want forever back again. To look into your eyes and hold you when you cry. It's not easy to say goodbye. I can remember all those great times we had. There were so many memories, some good, some bad. Yes, and through it all, those memories will last forever. There's peace in where you are. Maybe all I need to know. And if I listen to my heart, I'll hear your laughter once more. So I've got to say, I'm just glad you came my way. It's not easy to say goodbye.
I will never say you will never be.
into your eyes. And when I talk to you, it just echoes in my mind. Lord, if hearts are made of dust, and if we fell from the stars, I'd look up tonight and know just where you are.
Thank you. to give us comfort, to give us your word, Father. We have come to hear your voice today. And we ask that you speak to us kindly. We have come today to raise, Father, a beautiful soul. And we know that you will take care of it. You have also that you will take care of everyone. You are a Father of love. You are almighty. You comfort each and every one. You give us strength. You give us those things, Father, sometimes which we do not ask for. Yet, you are a Father of love. Father, bless our being here today. That we could say a last farewell to our dear sister Jane, who we love so much. Father, bless each and every one. Bless the family, Father. Those who ask questions. And we know you have the answers. We don't have them, Father. We pray that you instill in our hearts today that we can come to you. We can come where you will adhere to those things, Father, which we have asked for, which we have pleaded. Father, we acknowledge you. Bless us now, Father. Connect us with your pastorness. Fill us now with your peace, fill us with your joy, Father. Give us our strength. And Father, it's important for us when you send your son today. Pastors will never accept us away from us. Yes, we are humbly pray this in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, dear believing family, I read you a word today out of the book of Proverbs 31. And I read to us the verse 26 to 28. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and her tongue is the law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her household, and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. That's all.
Thank you.
my dear brothers and sisters, teacher. This is the crucial day that we were expected to come to the house of God. This is for us a very sad, it's not a nice day that we could come and then we would experience a day which is very sad. One would expect today that you would go out and shop, be with a friend, do what you want to do. Not expect that we would come and lay our most beautiful, beloved, gentle rest in our. And I want to also tell you, brothers and sisters, that you have actually adhered to a tool. Because when I look over to this, doesn't look like a divine funeral service. We have acknowledged a call to come in your spring clothes, to come in your colorful clothes. And I wrote in the apostle, to wrote in the apostolic history, because of Jonas and Quiz, could we also as servants maybe put on a pink suit? You could have wrote that and said, don't be a silly servant. But then we are here, brothers and sisters, to lay to rest. Share it with you. And if you would like me to, I would like to read it. It's a little bit, it's two pages, so I might not read everything. So, yeah, there are some poetry of Jamie Adrian's Adrian's, if you want to pronounce it, Lombard. We celebrate life, not death, by the going home of Jamie, 35 years old. Jamie was born on the 1st of September 1987 in Kensington as the only daughter of Joan and Frederick Lombard. In this family, consisting of four siblings, she was the second eldest amongst the three brothers. Her initial childhood commenced in Kensington until the family moved to Waterside, where she attended Waterside Primary and later Bosmansdam High School until she matriculated. After her schooling, Jamie attended various courses at varsity college. She pursued two jobs, opportunities, and ultimately followed her passion by enjoying baking in a private capacity. This resulted in a private little shop, E.A. Jamie's Cup Bakery, which afforded her many opportunities in displaying her talents. The crown of this achievement resulted in Jamie being selected to be a judge on the TV shows. Taste Masters Israel, aired as recent as August 2022. It did it right here in life. During this time, Jamie found herself very active in the Sunday school. She was in the youth, and she also sang in the special choirs. And many talents were also displayed in playing the orchestra, as well as teaching Sunday school in the local congregation. Whilst in her youth, she met Jody Adrians, 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 a beautiful relationship ensued, which culminated in marriage in 2012 in Waterside congregation. And out of this, Jamie had three children, Aiden, Jesse, and Dia. They moved from Waterside and they moved to Northway. This was their first home. Family. Needless to say, having three children demanded much of her attention. And yet, I have to add that Jamie loved, it's true that she loved her children very dearly and her children. She showed them with much love, patience, helping, even with his own work. Of special note is that she taught her children to pray and read them the Bible stories every night, to whom Jesus always was a girl. She wrote a personal journal, which I also read, brothers and sisters, Faith Over Fear. Her writings was beautiful. Jody expresses his gratitude for his love towards her. And then also, brothers and sisters, she writes here that she also thanks the doctors and thank each and every one of them. Over the past 2 years of our life, Jenny made many experiences and through suffering and hell, with many visits to various hospitals, she remained positive, joyful and inspiring, never broken. On Thursday the 9th, 20, March 23, she was admitted to hospital and she, in a few days after the treatment, she passed away peacefully on Wednesday, the 15th, 2023. We will miss you. You let them experience God. And I thought, in itself, that brothers and sisters can come out of somebody with a mouth, that has wisdom. Not going to have a mother again. That was the human factor that came to the fore, brothers and sisters. And then she left this beef. And then I left. And I drove to where I had to be. And I said to myself, would it be possible for you? Could you change that? Could you make her alive? She had to be there for the children. They're young. She had to be there for Germany. She had to take care of our household. Would you have changed the circumstances, Lord? Could you? Would you do that? I never got the answer. And I'm sure most of us, in our human capacity, we sometimes don't understand this. For us, it doesn't make sense at that moment. Although we are filled with faith, we have the Holy Spirit. But at that moment, and I thought about Jesus. When he hung there, he says to his Father, why did you forsake me in his human capacity? He said, Lord, said twice, why did you forsake me? He needed his Father at that moment. And our Heavenly Father didn't hear Jesus Christ in the human capacity. And I want to bring this in today in Jamie's life. That she almost says, you know what? I know you are mournful for me today. I know you are sad. And you, as I said, you, the family, Auntie John, Uncle Fred, you know, there will be a missing. But when you read the journal, brothers and sisters, you could almost say that she says here that, look, man, I have fought this fight. My race is complete. Here we as in our early capacity, we want to hang on to Jesus. We want to hold on for much longer. When Jesus was in the midst of his disciples, and he passed on, and then he came into their words, and they were sorrowful when you go read it in the book of John 16. He says today to them, you will have sorrow today. You know? Today you will have sorrow. But I will be your mercy. He says, and on that day, and maybe I read it to us, that we can have a proper perspective of those words, brothers and sisters. If I can find it. He says to them, therefore, you have now, today, you have sorrow. Ne? But I will see you again. This is the comfort of the words that he gave them, And your heart will rejoice. He says, you are sad now. You're going to sorrow. You are painful. You understand their dilemma. And he says to them further, and your joy, no one will take from you. And then he also says to them, and on that day, he says to them, you will ask me nothing. And on that day, I will be with you. In other words, he says to them that, I will tell you nothing today. Take the journey out of our lives. I will tell you nothing. And it sounds hard, brothers and sisters. It sounds that you want to ask the question. But he gave the comfort. He says, today you will have sorrow. Jody, today you will have sorrow, Jody. And but he says, on that day, when in the future, when I am with you, when you are with me, then I will ask you. And I think that is, for us, a beautiful comfort. That goes further, that says there, that, and on the tongue is the law of kindness. Brothers and sisters, we don't need to elaborate on this. The kindness that Jamie had was, just like the God said, the boys, unstable. When you get into her midst, when you speak to her, I went to go serve her, Holy Communion, and I knew she had pain, and I knew she was suffering. But when you serve her with Holy Communion, she had this beautiful smile on her face. This kindness falls. It's false. It says that tongue is the law of kindness. And I'm sure we have gone into this. Jamie was not perfect. But she had the law of kindness. When she speaks to you. And I almost wanted to say, brothers and sisters, Jody, if you want to make this possible, this journal, that we can all read this. You know, make it public. Because then we can, then you can see your heart, brothers and sisters. You can see a whole aura that she had about her. That she was kind. In actual fact, you always gave you a few instructions there also. I don't think I want to, like, how's this to the congregation? But she gave you beautiful instructions. But that was what she was. A lot of kindness. And she says here that, and she eat the bread of idols. You know, idols, brothers and sisters? When we speak of idols, we speak of kings. An idol, a noble, a person of love, of high authority. And also, and a children rise up and call a blessing. Jerome, each and every one, a children, a message. For Adrian, for Jesse. And I'm sure yesterday was his birthday, Adrian's birthday. This day will be for him significant. Because on this day, on this birthday, the next day, his mother was made to rest. And I'm sure this day will be with him. And Jody, you know, when they ask, how is mommy, how was mommy? Just let her lead her journey. Because each and every child is mentioned in there. She mentioned Jesse, Thea, and the children who were blessed. And she will be a blessing in yonder land. She was a blessing upon us here. When you get to the midst, and very humble also. You know, it mentioned there about a cupcake. You know, it sounds like she should be a small celebrity. But she was humble.
How?
She could say, you know what, this is secondary. When we had a conversation about this, she said, this was secondary. Firstly, our Heavenly Father. Then she could say to Jenny, you take my children to church. You pray for them. She could have given him all other instructions. How beautifully must raise them. Educate them. Give them all these. What is earthly? But what's so close to her was that she says to me, you take my children. The Lord will do the least. And we as the servants, my dear friend, John, we will also do our part. We will also embrace. We will also be there. Like we do. This responsibility of this task that we have, we will continue. And I'm not saying this, brothers and sisters, just to say beautiful words. You know, Tony Newton, a priest, said so much faith and love and confidence in the priest. The priest took care of her. He was there every moment when she needed him. What we always say, but yet, you have your own family. That is what we as the servants will do. And we don't come because, like I said, we want to give you your words. But this is our task. In actually, Jeremiah and Stark, that's also. That the servants will take care of you. So she's given us a beautiful task. And it's not our task, it's not our task. We can pray. Meet you on Thursday again, and we would speak. I could see your heart. You know, it's heavy. But you've also in peace. You've given the assurance, you've said to me, evangelist, I am okay. And when I drove away, then I thought, no, give him this thing. Because he has to endure months now. He has to take care of Aiden, which is young, Jesse, Thea. Because when I look at this and I look at myself and I say, Lord, will I be able to do that? You know, I will probably just call my daughter to help, call this to help, because I don't know if I can. You've asked the Lord to sing, and even God. And it says here, her husband also, and he prays. Beautiful. Today we want to lay in our hearts our dear sister to that. Beautiful. For those who do not, who maybe have not, can you contact with them? I will almost say that you have come in contact with a beautiful angel. She was, brothers and sisters, she was a person that when you also down, she could have left you. And you know also, add to this, she was a fighter. She fought for the better. She wrote in the journal, she says, you know what, Lord, I really thought I was coming through to this. When I heard that about my illness, I really thought that I was going to come through for my children, for my husband. And when I heard it, I almost said, Lord, could you have given her this? A wish? Could you? And today I said, yes, the Lord could. But we don't understand anything, brothers and sisters. We leave this in the hands of our Heavenly Father. He loves us. He has a place for us. He has a place where this earth will make no sense to us. This earthly life, brothers and sisters, where we find it so difficult to accept our faith sometimes, to accept those things that we don't want in our lives. We ask a lot of questions. Lord, why? Does it make sense to us sometimes that you will take this one and leave this one? To us, no, it doesn't make sense. But to our Heavenly Father, which has eternal life for us also. This earth, brothers and sisters, has been given us. It's still poor, it's temporary. We put so much emphasis on this earthly life. And when I say that, I don't mean that this is true. Yes, we have to continue with life. We have to work. We have to provide for our children. We have to educate ourselves. Nothing wrong with that. We have to do those things. It's important for the earthly existence. You have to buy yourself a house. If you can afford it, you have to buy yourself a house. We have to work. That our Heavenly Father knows. But when we said that, we don't put so much emphasis. Because these things will pass away. Today, the Lord says, you have sorrow. But on that day, in the future, when I come, I will give you all the answers. Then we can ask the question, we can have all the answers that we need. He says, Lord, why now? And brothers and sisters, you will give us the answers. And then we will have this opening understanding that, Lord, now I understand. Jody, now you will understand. Why? Why do you leave him with such a young, beautiful children? hear that, you will understand, and the Lord will bless us, brothers and sisters. Amen.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I will ask the congregation to rise. So you can get I now return the mortal body to the earth with the words, earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, soul and spirit. However, I commend to the love of Jesus Christ, who shall God only until the resurrection of eternal life. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Come this way. Dear Heavenly, we thank you, Father. Father, you, we come today, Father. We are thankful that we have this opportunity, Father, to lay our last respect to our dear sister. The service would you know, Father. And we ask that it should remain. That we always remember the legacy. That we always remember, Father, how faithful she was. How she loved her family, her children. And Father, let us, for us, let us do so wisely, Father. And let us also continue to do so. That we can learn from her to love our fellow men. Father, bless this day, fill us with your peace, fill us with your joy. And bless our servants, Father, bless our church for us. We humbly pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
Even now, as a child, all-star music can be
believe it, she loved Emma, my candidate. She loved the carpenters. She loved Roger Whittaker, for example. That was what Jamie loved. And one thing I can say that stood out about young Jamie, always positive, always thankful. Sylvia was saying that, but right? When they went to give her some lunch at the home, she was busy in the kitchen. Sylvia now, Jamie's laying on the bed because of the condition. She would phone Sylvia in the kitchen to say, thank you for helping in the kitchen, because she couldn't walk to get there. My goodness. And therefore, she was always the strength in her condition. She was the strength to the family. A living testimony of the journal which the evangelist referred to, faith over fear, a fighter, definitely. I read this journal, my goodness, you should hear it. It's a bestseller, pay the money. She, in most of the writings of this journal, she writes, dear Lord, dear God, dear my Father, in this other very personal ones, which I'm not going to stretch in the Joan side, the evangelist said so nicely, where she spoke with Joan and the children, and every day, dear Lord. She wrote there one day, remarkable to note, that one day she wrote there, you know, today I'm feeling angry. I'm a little bit upset today. I just want to have some grace. It's it. But that's how personal she was with the Father. Therefore, she had a relationship with him. But this Jamie never gave up. She married him. Up to the last, like 2 months ago, she still wanted to do things and achieve things, and she still wanted to go back and make a thing. You know, she had a stall at Route 44. So when you go there, think of Jamie. Think of Jamie's cupcake. And then she also said to some others here in the congregation today, we must catch up and we must still go to Tiger's cupcake. Okay? She didn't stop living. And I'm sure, hence we sang this opening today, Christ living in me, a life continues spiritually. And it's not the dead end for her. Absolutely. She always had this saying where she said, don't worry, we've got this. Up to the last. She says, don't worry, we've got this. And she always would be never shy to say, I love you. We visited her on the last few days before she passed, and as we live, she still said, I love you. My goodness. That was Jamie, always thankful. Can you believe that this young lady, in the worst moment of her life, that she intervened? The doctor spoke to her and told her the results for after a CT scan, and he told her that the scans had spread, and he wanted to tell her how long she's got to live. And she told the doctor, no, hold on, don't tell me, I just want to live. That's what she said, I just want to live. The doctor offered to pray with her, and she said, no, don't you pray with me. Allow me to pray for you, because you've got such a difficult job. You need to tell so many of us the stories, how long we've got to live. Come, I pray for you. Can you imagine that there was such rejoicing at that surgery? They couldn't believe that here they came out very jubilant. She could. And when she came home, the mother now wanted to know something. The doctor said, and she really casually walked there and said, ah, mommy, my father wants me home with you. Can you imagine? This was the faith of Jamie. And may we take this as a leaf out of her life. My father wants me home with you. She is the day of the Heavenly Father. And I take the comfort in a piece of scripture I like to read, where it says in Wisdom Solomon 3, the souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and they shall no more torment touch them. That I believe. No more torment for Jamie. No. As the man said, she will be rejoicing in the eternity. And it says so nicely, and having been a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded. For God has proved him, and God found Jamie worthy for himself. That I believe. And I'm sure that before me, that was Jamie's faith. And so lastly, Joni says Jamie was his rock. Jamie was his rock. His life partner, he struggled. He will miss the morning coffees for sure. Listening to music, watching movies, and the journey.
journey and the children, we will keep her alive through our praise and our fond memories of Joyce's. So, from Joey and the family, the Lombard family, mom and dad, they want to thank all for the many gestures of love, your kindness, and the immeasurable well wishes via the electronic media, telephone calls, and visits. So thank you also to all who today come to celebrate this. We celebrate the rejoice. And many thanks to all in attendance today, the congregation, the ministers, and all friend one. Thank you for your support coming from the family, to the neighbors as well, who did so much, the doctors and nurses of the various hospitals, the undertakers, the colleagues, the employers, and even those who decorated the house. A sincere thanks from Joey and the family to you all. And to end off, I wrote down a little quote that says, "Death takes the body, God takes the soul. Our mind holds the memory, our hearts keep the love, our faith lets us know that we will meet again." And this is what we look forward to meet with JPJ. I thank you and wish you all God's blessings and always thank you.
Oh,
Und Bob, wie liebe